with this.
Yeah.
Let me ask you something else too, just to kind of come full circle as we're kind of closing up. You know, people have asked me, I have my thoughts. I want to hear yours. You know, they say, why are food allergies so common today, maybe than ever before? I'll give you my opinion in a second, but I'd like to hear what your thoughts are.
So again, as we said, the food allergy prevalence increased over a decade. So you won't expect genetics to change so fast. So it should be related to things in the environment. So either factors in the environment or lifestyle. And both are implicated in different studies. So lifestyle, the age of introduction, and major factor. I mean, the fact that to introduce early won't eliminate completely peanut allergy, but it will certainly protect you at least 7 times more if you are not only introducing early, but continuing the introduction. Right? Because one of the things that I want to mention is some parents, you know, give it at the age of 5 months and then stop and then give it again at the age of 1 year and said, oh, I'm so surprised he got, anaphylactic reaction, but I gave it at 4 months. It's not only giving it.
No, you have
it's
to continue. Giving it.
Exactly. Yeah. You need to incorporate it in the diet regularly. Exactly. Right. And then factors in the environment. So many studies now suggest that the way we introduce things into our life, for example, there was a study about a rinse aid.